If you weren't a mindless undead, you'd be running right now. Maybe.
I am much more at ease in the forest.
Good to know. A bloodstone amulet. Chainmail. Skip the shield. Gauntlets. Some kind of unidentified gauntlets. There's a Bassilus' holy symbol. Depiction of the evil god Syric? Some kind of magical warhammer. Bolts. Ooh, crossbows. I don't think these are worth anything. It's a regular two-handed sword.
I'll do my best.
Just in case they sell for any good amount of gold. I'm not aware one way or the other.
Use your friends wisely. Not all are as trustworthy as Minsk.
Thank you for your kind words.
He's encumbered. Okay. So that's it for Bassilus and friends. The evil priest Bassilus seems to be insane. He believes that the undead that he controls are the living members of his family. He also believes that I am his parent. He didn't believe it for that long, unless he didn't care. He just wanted to kill his parent anyway. Nothing else around here, huh? Might as well finish exploring
plate and packing steel.
This area. So we return to the temple near Baragost for news of Bassilus, or to report our news of Bassilus, rather. Oh! Straggler skeleton here.
My blade will cut you down to size!
A bunch!
Your life shall be mine. My blade will cut you down to size.
Remember, there used to be a serious problem, skeletons. We can't get up there to explore. Okay. Back to the temple.
Butt kicking for goodness!
We just have to go around that way, don't we?
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
By the morning lord, I see that you have the holy symbol of Bassilus. It must have been a difficult battle to take down such a powerful man. Yours is a service that will not soon be forgotten. It is a pleasure to give you the full reward for which you have worked. Chihiro says, yes, I would have expected such opulence from these Lethanderites. In rewarding us, there is splendor and excessiveness in everything they do. 'Tis so out of balance. But all in all, at least they appreciate that a good deed has been done. Your help was indeed much appreciated. Alright. So I gained 1,000 experience, 5,000, whoa, 5,000 gold? That's nice. Did we go up with the... it was still average with our reputation. I have been well rewarded for dispatching the foul Bassilus. No doubt this 5,000 gold shall come in quite handy.
Don't touch me. I'm super important.
He's out of the potions we want.
You point, I punch. Butt kicking for goodness! Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Okay. I like that we're finally clearing out the little odds and ends of these areas. You must gather your party before venturing forth. Alright.
Full plate and packing steel.
Oh yeah. I'm gonna try to memorize this. I mean, identify this stuff. Let's see if I can sell these crossbows.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick! Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Alright, chainmail. Crossbow for 17 each. Okay, that's not bad. I have to identify this stuff. Boop. Oh, 10. I guess he... I guess Minsk has better charisma. Did better charisma than all of us? 9? No. Huh. They sold for more from him. I don't know why.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Okay, so I've actually got 3 things to identify. Watch, I'll sleep and then wake up and just know what the things are.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
The guy we killed over here was really tough. She had one magic missile I didn't need to use. Dragon. Okay.
Full plate and fucking steel.
Okay, take the bloodstone amulet. Well, it looked like he had...
Can I help you?
Nothing. He doesn't have anything. That didn't even happen like that.
Oh. You won't
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Oh, because we never gave him back this that he was holding on to. And wasn't he holding on to this for us, too? Maybe? Bashrik's hammer plus two. The priest of Moradin, Bashrik Sparklehammer, was considered wise and true, I think, and within the community of liberal dwarves. He continued to fight against the secession of the surface dwarves and generally relished a high reputation. This hammer, charged with the thunderbolts of Moradin, was his greatest weapon in the fight against evil. 1d4 plus 3 plus 1 electrical damage. That go plus 2. It's just, I don't know, 1d4 plus 3, is that really that great? Plus 1? I guess you always, as long as you hit, you always do 3 damage. Just wonder if it's as good as the other weapons we have. Plus we're not... I don't know if any of us are proficient in a warhammer. Twin sword, mace, longbow. Two weapon style. Long sword, axe, longbow. Warhammer. Maybe she could use it. So this is 1d6 plus 2. Meaning it does... 3 to 8 points of damage. There is a negative of 3, maximum of 8. 3 to 8, and then 1d4 plus 3 plus 1. So 1. So it's going to be 4, 5. Between, so the minimum is 5 then? So it's there, 3 and 1, yeah. 5, or 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5 to 8 damage. So 5 to 8 damage, or 2 to 8 damage. No. 3 to 8 damage. Really, this thing really does a minimum of 5? Yeah, 1 plus 3. Yeah. I'll have her use the hammer. And we'll sell that mace, I guess. Alright. I'm still identifying things. We've also got this warhammer. Ashadina plus 2. Lady Ashadina was a remarkable strategist who honed her skills against the orc armies in the Year of the Black Horde. She met Durgat Wiltoon, the warrior that wielded this weapon, when he foiled an ambush led by the great orc Varstok, and soon after made him her field captain. After serving at each other's side for the entirety of the war, they fell in love and eventually married. Historians report that Durgat named his warhammer after his bride to remind himself of the love he fought to protect. What Lady Ashadina thought of this is unknown. Okay, so this is 1d4 plus 3 plus 1 electrical damage. So it's the same. Yeah. Well, we'll sell that other warhammer. And then we've got this. Gauntlets. Ooh! Gauntlets of Fumbling. Elander's Gloves of Misplacement. With mischief in mind, the impetuous Elander set out to craft these cursed gauntlets to best a rival. It turns out his malice got the best of him when he mistook these gloves for another pair. Dexterity minus 2 may only be removed with a remove curse spell. Oh, good thing we didn't put them on. Alright. I wonder if we can even sell those.
By Valkor's mighty blade.
Oh, you're gonna? Okay.
I got some cheap beer for ya.
I don't think she's interested in your beer.
Less talk, more fight.
Squeaky wheel gets stucky.
Full plate and packing steel.
Okay, so off to Thunderhammers. Sell the rest of this stuff.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Terim's usually speechless lately. Flail plus 1, 1,000. You got it. Ashadina plus 2, 1,500. You'll take these bad gloves for 1. Or gauntlets, rather. Oh, there's another heavy crossbow. Oh, right, the gem bag. There's some gems in there. I'll come back another time for those.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Well, I think it's a good time to sign off now. That would be an awkward small video. Either that or one very long one. Let's go to the Nashkel Mines and look around the rest of that area.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
And must defend yourself.
Hobgoblins. Oh no, whatever will we do? I killed someone over here?
Full plate and packing. Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Rask! Go for the eyes!
I'm really not in this.
We're taking some damage.
Go My for blade the eyes, will Boo. Cut you down
Go
to
for
size.
The eyes!
Damn arrows. An Iol gem. We can say it. Sometimes we can't.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Maybe it even lets us rest here.
Full plate and packing steel.
All right. And almost half this map uncovered. And these mountains give way to forest. Interesting shadows. Oh, we're at a kobold.
Cool one, son. For goodness!
Yeah, shush. Yeah, I could probably do this. Yeah. Even though he doesn't use arrows, he can hold them that way. Too bad we don't find sling stones. We're starting to run out. Thank you. A wolf.
Your life shall be
give
mine.
Us victory! For the fallen!
My blade will cut you down to size!
You're okay. Yeah. I'm trying to decrease the piles, but... fight a lot of wolves and stuff, we will.
You boy,
butt kicking for goodness! Less talk, more fight!
Can't go that way? Oh. Oh no, there's a cliff face or something here. Hmm.
Who you are, no, not I. Who you are, no, not I.
Tells us? Galtok? Hey, wait. Please wait. You gotta help me. They're after me. They'll be here soon. Calm down. Tell us what's going on and we'll see if we can help you. The kobolds, dozens of them, they captured me and stripped me down. The dirty imps tortured me for no other reason than to hear me scream. But I got away. They'll be here soon. We have to run. Get out of here. Oh no, it's too late. They're here. I'll just kill them. Where are they? Where's... ah! You leave that guy alone, wherever the hell he went.
Go for the eyes, fool! Go for the eyes! Rask!
My blade will cut you down to size!
And our gem. Did someone level up? I thought I heard a level up sound. Oh, yep, Jahira, yay. Didn't she just level up recently? Thaco reduced by 1, additional hit points gained 7. Something? No, okay. Yeah, we still have some to uncover. He said there were a dozen of them? Or dozens? I counted 4. A winter wolf! Ooh! Their pelts sell for 500.
Go for the ice pool! Go for the ice!
Oh, it's... it casts cold. Oh boy.
Nature's servant awaits.
You casting that? I think I missed his portrait or something. Weaken the next one down a bit.
For the fallen!
Yes?
I got the killing blow. That's a lot of experience.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Doing well. Oh, they're pelts. Need that. Ten. Wow. Should we rest? Let's rest, and then we'll continue. We'll finish up. Good. To go infiltrating Nashkel to go sell the winter wolf pelts. Slipping past the guards and all that fun stuff. A regular wolf.
Oh, my heart's really not in this.
I don't think Jahira would complain, not him.
Tempest, give us victory!
No, my heart's really not in this.
Tempest, give us victory!
My blade will cut you down to size.
Almost done with one extra stack. Climb that. So they go around the mountain. Can I just okay? Nothing else here. Okay. That's it for the area outside the Nashkel Mines. Not much to be found, just some wolves and kobolds, and there's a bear up here, and you either fight one ghast or like three ghouls, I believe. found that out because the ghast killed us, and then we came back, and there was no ghast there, but three ghouls. I think it was three. Maybe two. I think three. Alright, so the other area we're going... Do I remember where it is this time? I believe it was this. Yeah, it was here. It was just south of Durlag's Tower. So we're not going to Durlag's Tower yet. Absolutely not. And I don't know what this means. I'm alive, I am. 'Tis nothing for me here now. That's the name of a place? So we're going here next. When we left the Nashkel Mines, we came out here near the, I believe it was the center, but definitely near the top, the north part of the map. So those four sisters, or whoever they were, they got us and killed one of us, so we had to flee that area. So we were definitely not at full strength, so we're going to return here and take a look around. And I'm not sure what next. We have some other areas to check out, I'm sure. Still never found those half-ogres. And I got the whole thing of Brage. You weren't able to find out. I swear, I looked and there was no body of his to pick up. I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be. But anyway, yeah, that'll be our next move. Gonna do some more random exploring and stuff like that before we make the next chapter go off and clear all our quests and stuff. I don't know if that's gonna happen every time, but that was unexpected. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.